What is up, people? Welcome back to Satori Graphics, the home of graphic design content right here on YouTube. So today we're going to have a lot of fun using the blend tool in Adobe Illustrator in today's Satori Graphics blend tool tutorial. I have another video using different variations on the blend tool in Illustrator. So after you watch this tutorial today, go down in the description below and check out that video too if you want to see more blend tool tutorials. But in today's video, however, select a color in the color palette and then press L for the ellipse tool. Generate a perfect circle by holding down shift. Use the alt option key to duplicate the circle two more times and then change the color of each circle. You want to choose colors that will work together well. So as you can see here, I've chosen warm and vibrant purples and pinks for my design. Click and drag to select all three circles and then use the two align functions in the align window here. Then go up to Object, Blend and Blend Options. We want to use the smooth color option here. Finally, go back up to Object, Blend, and then choose Make. You now have a sweet gradient using the blend tool, but we can do many things with this design. We can take the anchor point tool here and click and drag to edit the vector path like so. Secondly, we can go ahead and open up the brush window with F5 on your keyboard, or you can find it in the drop-down menu at the top. So with the blend tool creation that you've just made selected, go up to Create a New Brush in the top right window, and then click Art Brush. Make sure the line is running along the blend tool design perfectly, and then the default settings should be fine for your design. You've just created a vector brush using your gradient generated by the blend tool in Illustrator. So now when you make a pen tool path, you can simply press the brush in the brush window and you would apply the effect like so. You can have lots of fun with this and make some cool designs. Also, you can take the width tool here and edit the thickness of the line across the entire design. Also, if you have shapes constructed of strokes only, you can apply the blend tool brush creation to them like so. Change the stroke weight and also edit the paths as you see fit. And see what kind of designs you can come up with this method. You can cut parts of the line away with the scissors tool, and you can also use the direct selection tool to manipulate the design and the anchor points. So finally, I'm going to show you one last technique using the blend tool design that we made. Draw a path and then apply the brush to it, and then press R for the rotate tool. Click once on an anchor point and then hold down the Alt Option key and click again. In the window that appears, type in 6 degrees and then hit Copy. Now press Command or Control D over and over again to repeat the process. You can surely make some interesting and cool designs using all of these techniques, starting with the blend tool in Illustrator. So there is today's video, having some fun with the blend tool in Adobe Illustrator. Let me know what you guys thought of today's Adobe Illustrator blend tool tutorial down in the comment section below. And also, like and share my content if you do find it useful. Before I sign off today, I want to quickly show you some fan art that was made by Gustavo in relation to watching my video on anxiety and depression. Now this is a really cool design using the low poly method, and I think it's really, really great. So kudos to you, Gustavo, and thanks for sending me your fan art. If you guys have anything to send me, either link me in Twitter, or you can message me in YouTube directly and link me to your artwork, or whatever you want to show me. I'm always keen to see you guys' work and what you come up with in your graphic design workflow, so don't be shy. But anyway, until next time guys, design your future today. Peace.